We are live. Thank you. This is Patricia Dacre from Dealing With Your Diabetes and coming to you tonight to talk a little bit about one of my five foundational principles, which are emotions. As I coach, I've kind of grouped things into five things that I think are very important that are often overlooked in typical diabetes treatment and care, and those are education, which I think that hands down we have that covered, right? Everybody's really good about educating us about the disease process and how we deal with it. Second is about emotions, and I'm going to talk about that here in a minute. Number three is about motivation, what makes you decide to do what you do and why our behavior is as it is. Ownership, what it really looks like and how you step into doing what you want to do the way you want to do it. And communication, which are skills about sharing what you need and really being able to talk with other people. And those skills are very necessary to deal with some of the challenges that diabetes will throw at you. So tonight I'm going to focus on emotions. And I think it's common that people with diabetes have depression. But I also feel like sometimes that we get lumped in with clinical depression or other sorts of depression that we want to treat with medication. I'm not saying that that's not a good thing, but I think sometimes there's more to it and we're too quick to treat it with a pill. So when you think about emotions that come with diabetes, we talk about denial and anger and frustration and sadness, and it's all wrapped up in grief, right? So the first thing I think that when it comes to diabetes is a loss. Just like if someone dies, a part of you dies. And so when you look at the stages of grief, we have anger, denial first, then anger, bargaining, depression, and then acceptance. And if you can work your way through those things and get to a better place, that acceptance land is where you understand this is just what it is. This is how my life is going to be. And you stop wishing it were different. And that's just a great place to be. And it took me a long, long time to get there. And nobody really helped me through it until I sought help. And so my goal is to provide more of this information up front. So if you're struggling, you might find some of these concepts familiar, or you go, yeah, that's me too. And then we can look at, like, how do we tangle through that? How do we figure out, you know, what really is going on and what those emotions are for? So I think typically when you're diagnosed, especially if you're older, you know, there's this sense of back then, before, right? We all have kind of our diversity when it all started, and we remember before and after. Some people, if they're kids, not so much. But I think even if you've grown up with diabetes, you might have envy of other people who don't have to deal with the things we have to deal with. So all of those situations, so they're a burden, right? And they're hard. And they cause pain. And when there's pain, there's usually an emotional attachment. And when there's loss, so diabetes, we lose this life that we thought we were going to live. We lose really the ability to feel safe all the time. And we lose, you know, having a day off because we're doing this forever. And if we don't, we're still thinking about it. I mean, even if you decided one day to not check your blood sugar and maybe not even take your insulin, gosh, don't do that. But if you did, you're still worried about it. It's still this mental struggle. So all that mental energy balances with emotion. Focus a little bit more on the grief. So there is this loss, this sense of loss that you have, anger, denial, bargaining, depression. And we hear a lot about depression. And I feel like when you're dealing with diabetes, you don't get a day off. So it's constant, right? And over time that wears on you. So there are strategies that you can use to, let go of some of that, choose, make some choices, and choices is very empowering. So when you think about how the things you have to do for diabetes, there's different ways of approaching those so you don't feel so trapped and so without choice. I think the other thing is diabetes is a burden, right? It's hard. It's really hard work, and it's every day, and it's, you're always thinking, and again, that just really plays onto your emotional side. And so one of the things that helps with emotions, one is emotional intelligence, right? So what are the emotions? A lot of times we just feel bad. I know for me in the beginning, I just hated it. I just felt bad. And as I started to unwind the emotions and put names to them, it made it easier for me to manage and handle. So that's something, you know, that's really important. And I think the other thing is building up a sense of resilience so that even when you have a bad day or you feel a little bit bad, you know that life happens in a wave, right? There's ups and downs and ups and downs. And so that resilience is that faith and belief that it's going to come back up. So yeah, maybe I'm down today, but I'm going to keep moving forward. Easier said than done. So building resilience is what I coach about. And how do we find you and what you need and how you think about things and what your life challenges are? How do we figure out how to get you to where you can manage through all this? And it's definitely a skill that you can learn. I'm not going to talk to you too long, but I do want to say, you know, if you're struggling with emotions and you're feeling bad, reach out to someone, talk to somebody, especially if you have another friend that has diabetes that understands. It's a different sort of struggle, and it's really hard for other people. They can empathize, but they certainly wouldn't know. If you don't have anybody, call me. I offer a free 30-minute call, so it's on my website, on my Facebook page. You can get to that information, and you can set up a call, and we can chat about what I do and how you know, we can work together on your emotions, right? Because when your emotions are lighter, you just feel lighter, and everything gets a little easier. Lastly, the one last thing I'll say is I am working on home coaching videos, and there's a series of 5 videos that talks all about emotions and how to deal with them and some strategies. So it gets into the nitty gritty. There's exercises that you can do. And so, you know, take some, that's an opportunity if you don't want to work one-on-one that you could do the videos in the privacy of your own home. So they are not out yet. They're coming soon. But if you do go to my website, you can sign up to be an early adopter and you can get discounted pricing, and we'll probably release the first 5 videos soon, later this month. So you'll get a little sneak preview at those things. I think that's it. If you have any other questions or if there's some emotions that you're dealing with, please drop a note, call me, let me know. If you're interested in other topics, I can certainly talk about that. But I think really understanding that emotion, it's not just diet and exercise. We really have to deal with the emotional side of diabetes, of dealing with your diabetes. And that is my website, by the way, www.dealingwithyourdiabetes.com. So please check it out. Subscribe if you're not already a subscriber. And let me know if you have any questions. And I will see you next week. Thanks, everybody. Bye. I'm trying to in 2. Okay.